Hello everybody and welcome back to today's video. So I'm going to be using highlighters to paint a little landscape here that I've already drawn. I'm going to be using the Stabilo pastel highlighters. I absolutely love these. I found them in Michaels and instantly fell in love. And those are going to be the lighter colors and the less saturated colors. And to go along with those to make them darker and more saturated, I'm going to be using Sharpie click highlighters, like the little pen clicky things. So these come in, all of the colors of the rainbow. They're really dark and really saturated, though they aren't the neon colors that you would think of when you think of highlighters. The yellow one actually is pretty neon, but all of the others are a pretty non-neon color. I feel like I said that already. Anyways, but to start off, because I'm using highlighters, and this is the thing to keep in mind, is that they will not go lighter. Just like watercolor, where you want to start off with your lightest color, you want to do the same thing with highlighters. So I'm going to be doing all of the brightest points of the painting in my Stabilo yellow for the yellow of the flowers in the field, and also the yellow highlight that is going to be on the barn in the distance, because I want these two things to be the focal point. And then after, because of the tone gradients in the grass, I am starting off with the lightest green that I have, which is the Stabilo green, and I'm just coloring in all of the grass in this color, and also all of the trees in the background. They're all gonna get a base coat of this green, and it's going to, even though they're all gonna be different shades of green by the end, this base coat of green is going to harmonize those colors so that they look much more cohesive than if I did different color greens as the base coat. And also, when doing a highlighter painting, the highlighters will darken when you add more layers, which is something that I used for texture when I was putting in the base coat green for the grass. I was going through and adding perpendicular lines, vertical lines, actually. Vertical lines to indicate grass, especially for the sections that don't have any flowers. I want them to have some kind of visual interest as well. And I'm going in next with this pink, which I put over the entirety of the roof, and put in the center of all of the yellow splotches that will become flowers. And because highlighters, their purpose is to highlight something, they are very sheer. They're transparent. So when layering them, you will be blending them. If I put a pink onto a yellow, I won't get a pink on a yellow, I'll get an orange. Which is something that I kept in mind when I wanted to create these orange flowers, which I wanted them to have a darker orange center and a lighter orange petal. So I put a pink in the center, and then I did the Stabilo orange over top of both of them, which made a lighter petal and a darker center. And then I'm going in with this Sharpie light green and putting that in where there will be shadows in the grass, because obviously I want to create depth. And I'm using this dark green as something to add texture and to add very fine grass lines for, especially in the distance where I want the lines to be super, super tiny, because these Sharpie markers get an extremely fine point. I want them to be much more saturated than the green that I have down as the first layer, because it is a very pale green. And then I'm also going to take that light blue Sharpie and put them where there would be the shadows and the darkest points of the field, which would be like under the flowers, because obviously if they're taller than the grass, then they're going to cast much more of a shadow, and also it will define the stems of the flowers much more than they were before. And I also just add it here and there for a bit more depth. Then I'll be going into the very, very, very centers and underneath all of the petals of the flowers to just create depth and depth and depth. I mean, that's really all it is for highlighters. It's just you gotta layer and layer and layer the flowers in a way where each pass just makes everything more and more in focus and more defined. And it's actually like really fun to think about it, because it's a process that is extremely similar to watercolor, which is another medium that I love. And you'll see that I'm referencing a color chart that I made for all of the highlighters that I have, just so that I know what colors will look like layered on top of each other. And I wanted to get a pale purple, and that'll be just for the barn itself. Another thing to keep in mind with highlighters is that they are very, juicy? They're very juicy, and I'm just using a regular all-media type sketchbook, so they eat up the paper much faster than if you would use a marker paper or a watercolor paper. Something that is made to take much more water and much more liquid than a regular old sketchbook paper. So I had to be very careful, especially with these background trees, because I add a lot of passes of greens and blues and purples and some oranges you'll see in the very end. And by the time that I got to the oranges, there were little rolled up shreds of paper just on the page, and I kept having to brush it all away and stuff. When putting a whole bunch of different colors on top of each other, they lose their saturation and their vibrancy, and they become much more muted and extremely dark. And that was something that I really wanted for the back of the trees. So you'll see me just continuing to go over the same spots over and over, but with different colors, so that I get a really, really dark green. And eventually, when I put an orange over it, I get a really dark grayish brown, because the colors start to cancel each other out once you add opposing colors on the color wheel. Like, the Sharpie orange is a complementary color to the Sharpie blues. So those add like a really interesting color variation, and also aids in creating depth and darkness. And I found that the field in the foreground was looking really washed out, and it didn't pop out like how I wanted it to. And also I figured that because there's no big trees or anything, it's just a big open field, there would be a lot more warmth from the sunlight hitting them. So I just went over all of it in the Stabilo yellow, which is a beautiful golden. I'm obsessed with this yellow. It's not saturated like a normal highlighter at all, and it was exactly what I needed for these kinds of paintings. And you can see that I am using a Sharpie purple for outlining the shadows and the form of the barn, really putting to use the fine tip. It's extremely fine, and I use it to create the wood grain texture and everything. And now I'll be doing the orange pass, because I didn't like how all of the trees in the background kind of blended together, and it wasn't as depthful as I had wanted. I keep using the word depth, but like, there's really nothing else for it. Like, I wanted to make the trees in the background to have a lot more shadow. I wanted to push them back even further and create a bigger depth of field. So I added that orange to, like I said before, create a really, really dark green, like a muddy green. And it worked like really well, but also that was when the page just could not handle any more color. Although I think I do add just a little bit more color on it by the end. I think I add a yellow to it just to make the leaves on the trees pop even more. And then I also eat through the page where the barn is, just going over it again and again with different colors of the different shades of blues and purples and pinks, and then I think also eventually reds that I have. Oh, and yellows, adding yellow to the sides of the building that face the sun. And yeah, I mean, it's really all just layering and layering and layering. It took me quite a while to figure out the best way to go about creating a painting like this, because highlighters are not something that you would really think about not something that you would consider when thinking about possible mediums to use as paint, but I found that it was a really enjoyable and rewarding experience. So, I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I really, really liked making it. I really, really liked the process of using the highlighters. And if you want to create something like this, then I hope this video will help you as well. Maybe a kind of like do's and don'ts for highlighter paintings. And yes, that is all that I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Subscribe if you haven't. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at @_Manasa_, and I will see you later.